Good evening, everybody, live from downtown Temecula. It's Tuesday night city council meeting. How's everybody doing today? Let's see. We need an invocation. Do we have anybody online for invocation? All right. The Prime Minister, can you please give the invocation? And then, Mr. Caton, after that, do you mind giving the flag salute? Love to have you. Please stand.
Would you please stand? Bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we give you thanks for this day. We lift up the city of Temecula and all of its people. We pray for continued protection, good health, prosperity. We pray, Lord, over this meeting, this evening, the city council, city staff, for wisdom, for discernment. We lift up our first responders that are putting their lives in harm's way. Continue to protect them. And we pray over the blessings of our community and ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Okay, everybody, hands over your heart. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated. Madam Secretary of State, could you please give us the roll call?
Councilmember Edwards.
Here.
Councilmember Ron.
I'm here.
Councilmember Schwenk.
Here.
Councilmember Stewart.
Here.
Mayor Nagar.
I am here. I always like to see what students we have in the audience. So where are the Pumas? Are the Pumas here tonight? All right. Pumas in the house. Golden Bears.
Go Bears.
Golden Bears. Looking good. Wolf Pack. All right. Anybody here from Murrieta Schools? Did I see a hand go up over there?
You're just scratching,
just scratching, huh? Okay, no problem. All righty. Now's the time in our meeting for presentations and proclamations. I'm going to ask Mayor Pro Tem Stewart to go down. And you know what? We just had beautiful prelude music by the Spirit of Great Oak Band. And in fact, we'd like to go ahead and give a proclamation. Why don't you young folks come on up, come on down, okay? And let everybody have a good look
and
at
Jerry.
You. And Jerry, of course. Come on down. Jerry, you bless us so much every year. And parents, if you're here in a minute, it'll be picture time, okay? So come on down. And Mayor Pro Tem Stewart's going to read the proclamation.
Okay. To the Spirit of Great Oak Band and Guard, the City Council congratulates the Spirit of Great Oak Band and Guard on their outstanding accomplishments at the state, national, and international level. The Spirit of Great Oak Band and Guard, led by Director Jerry Burdick Roots, has earned several awards and recognitions over the past 15 years, including top honors in competitions throughout Southern California, the Fiesta Bowl National Band Championships, and the National Memorial Day Parade in Washington, D.C., the London New Year's Day Parade in 2013, LaGrange Parade de Paris in 2016 and 19, London New Year's Day Parade and Concert Gala Series featuring their jazz ensemble performing in Condongan Hall. The band traveled to England and Scotland and played in the 2013 New Year's Day Parade featuring a worldwide television performance in Parliament Square. We are proud of the Great Oak Band and Guard members for being selected for these distinguished performance events and for presenting their community, state, and nation. We wish them continued success in their future accomplishments. Thank you.
Jerry, would you like to say a few words?
Yes, actually. Thank you, that's very kind. I've actually learned that the students do a much better job of speaking, so I'm going to give each of our student leaders just a couple of seconds.
Good evening, I'm Junior Drum Major Bradley Beggs, and I had the honor of being the featured pianist
at Cadogan Hall with the jazz band, which is actually where the Royal Philharmonic performs. And it wasn't the art or the music or the sights in London that excited me the most, but it was the standing ovation we got while we were there, which was pretty cool. So thank you.
Hello, I'm also a junior drum major. My name is Gina Hahn, and it was a big honor to be able to lead the band into the special TV performance in Parliament Square. And it was also an honor to perform a flute duet with my friend Alex Miller at the Lord Mayor's reception following the parade.
Hi, I'm Drew Miller. I'm a senior drum major. I too, along with the rest of the drum majors, was honored at the Lord Mayor of Westminster's reception in London following our marching band and our jazz band performances, where we received some commendation for being pretty awesome.
Sounds good. Jerry, did you want to say anything else? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't.
It's okay. Yeah. I'm Savannah Schaefer, and I'm also a senior drum major, and I went to both the London performance and the Paris performance, and traveling is just one of my dreams, and to combine it with music has just been an honor. So thank you so much for giving us this. It's been amazing.
Not captured in that video was the sound, and I just wanted to make sure that you all know that they gave props to the city of Temecula, Pechanga, as well as our wonderful wineries. So they gave us the full gambit of recognition. That was a very proud moment. So thank
Tell
you.
Tell Stephen I said hi.
I will do that.
So I think it's so cool you guys were able to do that, and your talents are well known here in Temecula. You always come through for us, and we enjoy having you all the time. Parents, if you'd like, now's a good time to come on down, take some good pictures while you're here, and don't be shy. And take your time, and you can take pictures together, pictures separately, whatever you want to do.
While they're doing that, maybe we can discuss the title change to Lord Mayor. I kind of thought that had an interesting ring to it. I don't know, Mike.
You like
you know,
that? Oh,
yeah. It's your call. You're the mayor this year, but just thought I'd throw it out there.
And if you would see, when he goes in public, he has to wear a fur-lined, full-length robe, and it has fur down the front, and he wears a big medallion around his neck. It's about this big.
If you let me do a powdered wig, I'm in.
Oh, he does.
Okay.
He does.
We would provide the trumpets every time you enter a room.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. I think I'll tone it down a little, Councilmember Ron. I think you got your point across.
I can see you in the fur-lined robe, though.
No, I'm kidding. Thank you very much. And always good to see you guys. Okay. Normally, this would be a time for public comments, but I'm going to take things a little bit out of order in the interest of being efficient. So right now, I'm going to go to where we're going to conduct. Let me take you there. Let's see. Just before item 16, I'm going to go ahead and convene a joint meeting of the City Council. Do I have to recess the meeting first, Mr. City Manager, or can I just convene the joint meeting? Or Mr. City Attorney?
The joint meeting for the emergency?
No, this is joint meeting of the City Council and the CSD.
No, you just say that you're going to recess the City Council meeting.
Very good. So I recess the City Council meeting, and then I'm going to convene joint meeting of the City Council and Temecula Community Services District. We're going to go to item 16 on the agenda. Do you want us to approve, Madam City Clerk, item 16 first, or you want to take the presentation first?
Mr. Mayor, as we have no public comments on this item, unless the council has any questions of our finance director, we can go ahead and approve this under consent, and then we can go ahead and have the speaker come and do his presentation.
So very good. On the consent calendar, all matters listed under consent are considered routine and will be enacted by one roll call vote. There'll be no discussion of these items unless members of the City Council or the Board of Directors request specific items to be removed from the consent calendar. Item 16. Approve fiscal year 2018-19 mid-year budget adjustments. I'll go ahead and take a motion.
Move approval.
Second.
That was Councilmember Edwards, seconded by Mayor Pro Tem Stewart. Go ahead and log your votes. Did you want to, can you do both of these at one time, or you want a voice vote?
Mr. Mayor, let's go ahead and do a voice vote.
Okay. All in favor, say aye.
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 All against, passes unanimously. We have one business item, item 17, receive and file presentation from Roger Alfaro of Vavrinic Tribe Day and Company, LLP, regarding the annual CAFR report. Can we have a staff report, please?
Sure. Good evening, Mayor and Council members. As required by the Municipal Code and California state law, an independent audit is annually conducted on the city's financial statements. The audit, the annual financial report, is known as the Comprehensive Annual Financial Report, or CAFR for short, and it communicates the city's financial condition and activities for the year ended. The city's current independent auditors, Vavrinic Tribe Day and Company, LLP, known as VTD, performed the audit for the most recent years ended. And Roger Alfaro is here tonight to present the CAFR. But first, I want to recognize the efforts of fiscal services managers, both Rudy Graciano and Pascal Brown, as well as the entire finance department for their hard work in completing this year's audit and their diligence all year long to keep the city in compliance with the governmental accounting standards. And with that, I'll turn it over to Roger Alfaro.
Roger, welcome.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, Council members. I'm Roger Alfaro with Vavrinic Tribe Day and Company, the external auditor. As your external auditor, our role is to express an opinion as to whether the financial statements are also, as it's been referenced, the comprehensive annual financial report, which is the responsibility of management. Our charge is to determine whether those financial statements are fairly presented. The audit process itself spans several months, beginning with our risk assessment phase of the audit. During that risk assessment phase, our focus is to obtain an understanding of certain transactions or key transactions that have been undertaken during the year by the city, as well as to update our understanding of the internal controls that the city has in place to ensure accurate financial reporting, mitigate fraud, as well as ensure safeguarding of assets and compliance with laws and regulations that could have an impact on the financial statements. We use this understanding in the work that we do during our risk assessment phase to determine the nature, timing, and the types of audit tests we're going to perform on the account balances and the disclosures that are contained within the financial statements. Once the books are closed, we come in and we perform our specific tests. Our tests include independent third-party confirmation, where we reach out to various parties to validate transactions that have occurred during the year. We also perform analytical procedures, and on a test basis, sample transactions and vouch and trace those transactions to underlying supporting documentation, such as invoices, time cards, contracts, or other types of agreements to verify that those items are properly presented in the financial statements. Based on all of this work, all this evidence that we've gathered, we've issued an unmodified opinion on the financial statements that's also referred to as a clean opinion on the financial statements and is the highest level of assurance you can achieve in the financial statement audit. One of the items that I'd like to point out is in our current year auditor's report, we include what's referred to as an emphasis of matter, and that identifies that the city has adopted new accounting policies which were required in this fiscal year as set forth by accounting standard setters with respect to the accounting for other post-employment benefits. So those liabilities have been properly captured and reflected in this year's financial statements. In accordance with our work and professional standards, we have also issued a document referred to as the Report on Internal Control Over Financial Reporting. That document states that we did not identify any material weaknesses in the internal controls over financial reporting based on the work that we've performed. In addition, we're currently working on the audit of federal grants, where we perform tests in accordance with federal guidelines, and that report is anticipated to be issued and completed before March 31st. We're pleased to report that we did not encounter any disagreements with management with respect to any accounting, auditing, or financial related matters, nor did we have any difficulties in the conduct of our work. City staff was professional in providing us access to individuals within the organization, as well as access to the documents and third parties so that we could conduct our field work and complete our audit process. And so with that, this concludes my remarks on the audit process for the fiscal year ended June 30th, 2018.
Thank you very much. Are there any questions of either our staff? Okay, Madam City Clerk, are there any requests to speak?
There are none, Mr. Mayor.
Well, this is a receive and file, so without any further ado, we will receive it and file it.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here tonight. Okay, let's see here. At this time, I'm going to adjourn this joint meeting of the Temecula Community Services District and the Temecula City Council, and I'm going to reconvene the Temecula City Council meeting, and we're going to go to the public comment portion of our meeting. Madam City Clerk, do we have any public comments?
Mr. Mayor, we do not.
Okay, so we'll dispense with the video for this week, and we will go to City Council reports. Do my colleagues have anything they wish to say? Screen. I don't see anybody in the queue, so we will dispense with City Council reports and go on to the consent calendar. All matters listed under the consent calendar are considered to be routine and will be enacted by one roll call vote. There will be no discussion of these items unless members of the City Council request specific items be removed from the consent calendar for a separate action. 1, waive reading of standard ordinances and resolution. 2, approve action minutes from February 12, 2019. 3, list of demands, that's the checks we write. 4, approve the city treasurer's report as of December 31st, 2018. 5, approve the purchase from BMW Motorcycles of Riverside of one BMW police motorcycle for the Temecula Police Department. 6, receive and file support for providing assistance to the Riverside County District Attorney Cannabis Regulation Task Force. 7, approve the exclusive negotiating agreement between the city and Stephen A. Bieri Company for the potential disposition of city-owned property located at the northwest corner of Diaz Road and Dendy Parkway, APN 909-370-049. And APN 909-370-050. 8, approve specifications and authorize solicitation of construction bids for pavement rehabilitation program, Enterprise Circle West and South Right-of-Way and Commerce Center Drive, Public Works 18-12. 9, approve an agreement with Courtesy Chevrolet Center for the purchase of 2 2019 Chevrolet 2500 HD LT double cab 4x4 vehicles. 10, approve an agreement for consultant services with NV5 Inc. for the Margarita Recreation Center project, Public Works 17-21. 11, approve a non-exclusive commodity agreement with Musco Sports Lighting LLC for the purchase of multi-use field lighting equipment at Paula Park Soccer Field. 12, approve a funding agreement between the City of Temecula and Riverside County Flood Control and Water Conservation District for cleanup of trash, debris, and other items on district-owned property. And 13, approve application for the CAL FIRE Urban Forestry Grant Program through the California Proposition 68 Fund. Do I have a motion to approve the consent calendar?
Second.
That was moved by Councilmember Edwards, if you can enter your vote, and seconded by Mayor Pro Tem Stewart.
It's frozen.
Are we frozen out?
I am.
It's okay. We can do a voice vote.
A voice vote, please.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That passes 5-0 with no opposition. Let's have a look. That's moving right along. Alrighty. At this time, I'm going to recess. Well, actually, do we need a separate meeting? No, we don't, of the Temecula Community Services District. Sorry, buddy. Okay.
That's it.
Mr. Mayor,
we do?
Yeah.
Oh, we do. Well, I take it back. All right. I'm going to recess the Temecula City Council meeting and turn the gavel over to President Stewart of the Temecula Community Service District.
All right, so we are convening the Temecula Community Service District meeting. Madam Clerk, we are all present. Are there any speakers? Okay, we have a rousing agenda of approving the action minutes of February 12, 2019.
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded by Mr. Mayor Nagar and, what's your name?
Yeah, that would be me.
Yeah, her. All
those I'm the
favor?
Girl.
Aye.
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 All right. Director's report.
Mr. President, all things Rod Run, and as we were discussing earlier, rain or shine, the show will go on. And beginning with the Friday night cruise and then Saturday's show and shine event here in historic Old Town. Now, sold out since last year with over 570 registered vehicles, thanks to all the participants that are calling and emailing to confirm their attendance, as we also monitor weather conditions. And if the need arises, we are exploring options for another showcase, possibly later in the year, in addition to possible modifications and enhancements for next year. Until then, stay tuned and see you all at Southern California's premier car show, the 2019 Temecula Rod Run. And that, Mr. President, is a rousing report. That concludes my report.
All right, general matters report.
Nothing further, Mr. President.
All right, board of directors, anybody?
Nope.
All right, then we will adjourn and reconvene on March 12th.
At this time, I'm going to go ahead and convene the successor agency to the Temecula Redevelopment Agency. Madam City Clerk, let the record reflect that all SARDA members are present. We have one item on the agenda. It's a consent item. Approve the minutes of February 12, 2019. Can I have a motion?
Move approval.
Second.
That was Councilmember Edwards, Mayor Pro Tem Stewart. Would you like a voice vote?
Please.
Sounds good. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? That's 5-0. Executive Director, anything?
Nothing further.
Any Board of Directors comments? Okay, we're going to go ahead and adjourn this meeting till March 12, 2019. Very good. All righty. Let's see what's next. Let's see. All right, now's the time. We're going to go ahead and convene a joint meeting of the City Council and the Public Traffic Safety Commission. Item 18, conduct the annual joint meeting between the City Council and the Public Traffic Safety Commission. Do we have a staff report, or how would you like to proceed?
I'll let Public Works Director Pat Thomas sort of tee it up for Chairperson Sullivan, who has a presentation tonight.
Thanks, Aaron. Yes, our chairman of our commission, Mr. Brad Sullivan, is here to present to you what the commission has done over the past year and what is on the agenda for the future. So take it away, Mr. Sullivan.
Thank you. Mr. Mayor, members of City Council, distinguished management, it's our pleasure to be here tonight and report on the actions this last year of the Temecula Public Safety and Traffic Commission, as well as items that are on the horizon and coming towards us. Before making the presentation, I'd like to introduce a couple of the commissioners that were able to be here tonight. On your far left is Skip Carter. He's the vice chair this year of our commission. Next to him is Bob Hagel. He's our most senior member, not in his generic years, but actually in terms of service, I guess. Yeah, he's our equivalent of John Telesio on planning. And then, of course, our volunteer, Jerry Gonzalez.
Volunteer.
Every commission report that's come to you the last few years I've been on the commission, not just from ours, always provides amazing accolades for the staff they work with and the employees of the city. And we don't come with that viewpoint. We come with a viewpoint that we don't want to take anything away from Luke, Patrick, Jennifer, Kevin, or any other member of the staff here. I'll just tell you that the commission feels that Patrick and his team live up to all the accolades that every other department chair has received. And Mr. Adams, I can just share with you, having worked at other cities as volunteers, you have put together a team that is so responsible and so incredible, it actually makes it a pleasure to volunteer. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, that's a very good comment. Thank you, Brad.
Thank you. Yeah. All right. So starting our report, the Public Traffic Safety Commission is responsible for dealing with a variety of issues that are related to the goals identified in the city's core values. The City's core values include transportation, mobility, and connectivity, a safe and prepared community, a sustainable city, accountable and responsive city government, which we really have, and a healthy and livable city. One of the major programs that we implement to improve quality of life and safety in Temecula is the Neighborhood Traffic Calming Program. The purpose of this program promotes community involvement by proactively addressing traffic improvements to maintain a safe and friendly environment. This is accomplished by addressing concerns about excessive speeds on residential streets with our residents and implementing traffic calming features, including but not limited to edge line striping, parking lane striping, medians, bike lanes, and chicanes. And I've got to arrow this down. Give me a second. I think I went too far. Give me one more second. This is my annual getting lost in the picture slide. So
take your time.
All right, here we go. So up on the picture right now is a picture of traffic calming that has been utilized on Channel Street. As you can see, there's a notification that there's a stop ahead, and then there is a stop sign that's been added to that area. That's a four-way intersection on the right picture there, and because of the curve in the lane, visibility sometimes could be a risky issue, so now by doing this, it's a much safer intersection. Here we again have a Channel Street traffic calming. This is a Crown Hill Drive stop signs and crosswalks that were added again to improve pedestrian traffic and the safety of the intersection. The commission also works actively to promote consideration and implementation of traffic control devices to ensure the safety of Temecula motorists and maintain a safe and family-friendly environment. The commission has considered the traffic control devices shown in the slide, which include protected permissive signal operation, Red Hawk Parkway at El Camisal, I hope I'm saying that right, and Tehachapi Pass traffic signal, Golf Cart crossing, signing, and marking upgrades at Honors Drive and Brassy Lane always stop control. In regards to the protected and permissive traffic signal on El Camisal, thank you. The following were recently installed, which provided protected left turn, and when left turn demands are heavy, this otherwise left turn function is permissive, otherwise allowing vehicles to turn left on the green ball, and that again promotes safety under high traffic conditions at that intersection. Here you can see the all-way stop control added to the Honors and Brassery lane. Again, this is a street that's got a hillside, and up on the far end there you can see as well a curve, and it was residents that were concerned about the safety issue of not being able to see visible traffic approaching, and by implementing these traffic control devices, again, it's improved the quality and safety of the intersection. We also take an active role in ensuring the safety of pedestrians, bicyclists, and any mode of transportation here by reviewing and considering projects such as those listed in the slide. So for many years, there was an issue with the Great Oak High School pedestrian crossing. This past year, the council approved and it's been installed a new crossing that has LED lighting, advanced notification, and also a cooperative agreement with Great Oaks that during the morning sessions and the evening sessions when students are coming and guarding, there's a crossing walk, and so far the monitoring seems to show a very beneficial improvement. High visibility on Deer Hollow Way, such as a Great Oak High School, is the first installation of its kind in the city, and those are the notification LED lightings and arrows that I was discussing. And there's other potential benefits to this, as the city can benefit from this installation in other areas. It's also probably one of the most least expensive safety controls for pedestrians, and if it's not sufficiently effective, it is movable to another intersection, so there is no loss to the city. In keeping with the city's trails and bicycle facilities master plan, the commission reviews and considers the implementation of bicycle facilities that complement and complete missing links within the network, such as the location shown in the slide between existing bike lanes on Temecula Parkway and Via Rio Temecula. The commission takes an active role in interviewing and providing input on the transportation circulation process. This ensures the safety of Temecula residents, and the activities include CIP, citywide speed control limits, as demonstrated up there. So we have the citywide buffered bike lane program, the Sharrow program, highway safety improvement program, and installation upgrades of signal equipment at 43 intersections, closed circuit televisions in 14, and adaptive signal timing at Winchester Road, California Road, and Temecula Parkway. This slide depicts the intersections, the red circles, CCTV locations are the blue squares, and the three arterials to receive upgrades under the Cycle 8 grant, which is provided. So this is valued at approximately $1.3 million and is part of the long-term plan to mitigate traffic issues in Temecula. We also interact very closely with the Temecula Police Department and Fire Department. The Temecula Police Department offers some wonderful programs. Hopefully you're all familiar with the Every 15 Minute program, which is a scenario of an accident of an impaired driver, and they literally create with makeup and everything else, they get wrecked vehicles. It is so real that the kids are visibly shaken. They show having to cut people out of cars. They show them taking off in ambulances. It gets very real. And the school supplies emotional support counselors and also therapeutic dogs to help the students get back to their comfort zone, because it's so impressive on the reason not to drink and drive or be under the influence. Our DUI checkpoint program in Temecula is continuing to be very effective with reductions in fatalities and with the number of accidents involving under the influence. The Community Action Patrol, which is a volunteer program, where we have volunteers out there being the eyes and ears for the police department, and these volunteers are saving the city a lot of money because they are doing work that we don't have to pay uniformed officers to perform. The problem-oriented policing team, the special enforcement team, and the homeless outreach team programs, our stoplight abuse program, Mr. Mayor Pro Tem, which I can now answer this year. Last year surprised me. Our crime prevention through environmental design. This is a wonderful program. The police department makes itself available to businesses and residents in Temecula to come out and make recommendations on your property to make yourself less vulnerable to crime. So that would include improving lighting, removing landscaping that may be blocking access points, and then, of course, coffee with a cop. And this is a great program because the chief of police is always there, our leadership is there, our traffic officers are there, and it creates a wonderful opportunity for residents of Temecula to discuss their concerns on any policing issue or any traffic issue. And I can share with you that each time the department takes away some valuable information and adjusts its response and resolves those issues. We interact with the fire department. They provide safety and classes and certifications, including CPR and AED, first aid, community emergency response team, and the healthcare provider CPR certification. They also have a wonderful public outreach program. They attend safety fairs such as here at the mall or at my HOA Wolf Creek, and they have a fire safety trailer to educate the children and youth of Temecula on what to do in case there's a fire, and it's a great asset. Issues that we're looking, coming up on the horizon are obviously autonomous vehicles that may create a need to recommend some laws and ordinances to mitigate potential risks that may be involved for our motorists. Continued traffic calming issues, which we are now going to be studying at Delray Road and Via Norte Loop. Red Hawk Passway and Vail Ranch Parkway. The continued use of the neighborhood traffic calming program, time-limited parking restrictions, public facilities, Meadow Parkway buffered bike lanes, Rancho California Road to De Portola, and highway safety improvement programs under Cycle 9. So in addition, just recently completed and having a positive impact was an additional left turn lane on Wolf Valley just as you approach Red Hawk, and this provides two left-hand turn lanes. It prevents a backup. It also provides a safer access for the parents making a left turn to pick up their kids at the elementary school there. So that concludes our report, and I'm happy to answer any questions, and the commission is here to take any input you may have.
Thank you, and that was a very good report, Brad.
Thank you.
Any questions or comments? I'd like to keep the meeting somewhat informal. So is there any dialogue the council wants to have with the Traffic Safety Commission?
I think it's impressive when you see all the different programs and all the impacts that traffic safety has. And I have served on that commission, and I really learned a lot, and I enjoyed it. So doing a great job, everybody. Great job.
Yeah, thank you. We've got incredible staff, not taking anything away from anybody else. Mm-hmm.
So are you in charge of fixing all the potholes after the rain?
I'll let Patrick handle that.
Sorry, Patrick.
But I must share with you that I have been in touch with Patrick on raised sidewalks and potholes, and he's always said to me, I'll have it fixed the next day. And every time when I've driven by the next day to check, it's fixed. So the response is incredible.
I know that giant sinkhole was fixed in record time.
Oh, yes, yes. Patrick, do you have anything you wish to add?
Well, the maintenance of the roads typically is not something under the Traffic Safety Commission purview, but we do have an excellent maintenance department. So they are, as the chairman mentioned, our folks are super responsive. And anytime anyone out in the community sees a pothole and wants to report that, you can call that in. We've got a mobile app you can report that with. So the people in the community are the eyes and ears for the city staff. So anything that gets reported, we attend to quickly.
Thank you. Mayor Pro Tem.
Yeah, I was going to mention about the traffic calming things that you do. It's super important because there's a lot of blind corners. There's a lot of speed limits that are not followed. And, you know, by creating stop signs in places strategically does slow people down. And especially around blind corners and such like that. So that to me is a very important thing that you guys do. And I'm glad you guys actually go out there and do the legwork and kind of examine it before it comes to us, because you guys already vetted it. So that's something I think people don't quite understand. Why did we put that stop sign there? Well, we put it there for a reason. And it may not necessarily be to just because that intersection needed a stop sign, but the traffic going through that intersection needed a stop sign.
Right.
So to slow it down. So
yeah, we had first of all, I'd just like to comment and share that my fellow commissioners and I on all of these issues have done independent site visits for all these recommendations, and it's wonderful to work with them because they are aware of what the conditions actually look like. They've been there, they visualized it, and sometimes come back with further recommendations. A great example of a successful traffic calming program is on Pina Colada. While the results are still being studied and effects modified, we put restrictions on the morning and evening commutes so that you couldn't make right and left turns from La Serena onto Pina Colada. That greatly reduced the traffic volume, and it also reduced the speed. The residents on Pina Colada were complaining they couldn't safely get in and out of their driveway during those hours. We also put a traffic calming sign, solar implemented sign that has the speed limit and then above it a digital readout of what you're doing. So if you're flying along and not thinking, it does bring it to your attention, and it has improved the conditions substantially.
Mm-hmm. Anyone else?
Well, real quick, I just want to say thanks for the report. And you know, I think we started this a couple of years ago where we started doing annual reports and joint meetings between the different boards and commissions. I think it's hopefully it's been useful. Hopefully it's good for all of us. Mm-hmm. Keep that interaction discussion. But I think importantly too, gives us all a chance to see all the hard work you do all year round, and our residents as well, because I'm not sure they always show up to the traffic safety meetings, but they do when that signal or that stop sign is on their street.
Yeah, exactly.
So, you know, but really do appreciate the annual update and taking the time with us. Thank you.
It's our pleasure. Thank you.
Yes. I will tell you, you paid staff a very good compliment, so I'd like to pay you folks a compliment back. I remember something that Councilmember Schwenk said a couple of weeks ago, and that was, it is what you make of it, how much time you put into the commission work. And it's clear that you folks on the commission put in the time. Your presentation today demonstrates to us and to the public, and we knew a lot of the things that you're doing, mm-hmm. but that's a lot of work for a volunteer position. And oftentimes I know you have to go out and look at things on your own time, and it's not just coming to a meeting and making decisions. So that's really appreciated. And then the last thing I'll say is, because you handle those things on your level, by the time it gets up to us, it's pretty much all worked out.
Mm-hmm. That's our goal.
That's the goal, and that's you guys are achieving it. So well done, and thank you.
Thank you. It's all, you know, the most important part with this is that all of this creates a safer environment. And anything we can do to make our children, pedestrians, and vehicles safer, that's our goal. And we all derive great pleasure from doing it. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. See, no more comments. Let's see where I'm at here. I'm going to go ahead. Is there any other comment by any of my colleagues on the joint meeting? Okay. I'm going to go ahead and adjourn this joint meeting of the Temecula City Council and the Public Traffic Safety Commission and reconvene the Temecula City Council meeting. Let's see what we have. Commission reports. Brad, you gave yours. Commissioner Watts from the Planning Commission.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Mayor, council members. We just had a meeting last week, and we elected a new chair. We were going to draw straws, but for some reason, straws aren't as easy to get anymore as they used to be. But I was elected the chair, and Lene Turley Trejo, Commissioner Trejo, will be the vice chair for this year. We also approved a 60-unit affordable multifamily development on Pujol Street, and it will have 15 units that are dedicated to special needs people. So that's great news. We approved a redo of Pat and Oscar's at the Duck Pond. They came in with a lot of new ideas to spruce up the place, and they're going to include a new brewery, I think, inside as well. So that's exciting, and that will go along with the improvements we made at the park that will just continue to make it shine over there. We also approved a park and ride facility in the Rorapaw Ranch area that was part of the approved EIR several years ago, and it will provide 50 spaces for those that want to park there and ride, and it will also have, I think, 12 spaces for people that have horse trailers for drive-through spots for them to enjoy the facility and use it. So that is our update, and I'll leave it to you. Thank you.
Sounds like you folks have been busy. I see Chairman Commissioner Turley Trejo. Congratulations on that. Well deserved, I might add. Let's see. How about Community Services Commission, Commissioner Borgensen? Do you have anything for us tonight?
Yes, I do. I'm just acting or filling in for this month, and next month we'll be selecting our new chairperson going forward. Along those lines, I'd like to thank the City Council for your role in finding us two new members. Big shoes to fill,
yeah,
from the previous commissioners that we now are welcoming Gary Audi and Adam Ruiz, very talented, very enthusiastic, and we had one meeting already with those gentlemen, and they superior. They come with great enthusiasm and talent. So we're looking forward to great things continuing with our commission. Just to add to Director Hawkins' comments about the Rod Run, some additional things about that. We anticipate, given good weather, 60,000 people in attendance on Friday and Saturday for that event. Don told me that the registration for cars began in mid-August and they were filled by later in September. So that's pretty fantastic. People coming from as far away as Arizona, Canada, Alaska, Texas. So this is certainly a premier event. And just so you know, I will be judging that event, and I feel highly qualified since I was in high school the owner of a 67 Camaro 396, Kragers, raised white letters, Goodyear tires. So I'm looking forward to that experience on Saturday. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you for that report. Do you still own the Camaro?
I wish I did. Yeah. That would be a very valuable. Well, what happened was, you might remember the oil embargoes of that time period and waiting in line to buy gas. I sold the Camaro and bought a Volkswagen. Bad decision.
Thank you. Our chief of police, public safety report. Chief, do you have anything for us tonight?
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, City Council, and staff. We, too, are looking forward to the Rod Run. We have faith that the rain is going to hold off, and we're going to have a great year with all the cars that are coming out. For the month of January, we had 7,039 calls for service that we responded to. Of that, 1,293 were traffic citations, with an additional 154 parking citations. We investigated 66 traffic accidents and 25 DUI investigations. Our commercial enforcement officer issued 50 citations. He was on a roll this month. He was out in full force. And then our loitering and panhandling, we had 89 calls for service and 8 actual outreach files that were pulled. And that is it.
Thank you very much, Chief. City Manager, anything for us tonight?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, just a few things. I believe I have a slide I'd like to put up. And this is directly related to an item that you're going to be considering, the City Council will be considering here in a few minutes, with respect to the storm that hit Temecula in the south part of California here last week. On Thursday, we measured over five inches of rain. And so these are just some pictures of Marietta Creek, the south end of town. Obviously wreaked havoc on Temecula. And I got to give props and a shout out to our Public Works Department, Rodney Tidwell, Pat Thomas, the entire team, because they were working through the night with equipment, getting roads reopened, debris cleared. Not an easy task. So to our Public Works team, I just wanted to especially say thank you for that. Yes. Another item I couldn't let go, I hope it's okay, Mr. Mayor, was earlier this evening we had a auditor here recognizing the good work of Jennifer Hennessy and the finance team on the CAFR and a clean audit. We're managing on any given year, you know, close to $500 million between the capital budget and the annual operating budget. And to get an objective outside opinion on the management of our financial reports isn't a small thing. It isn't something that I wanted to let go. And so forgive me, but Jennifer and her team are to be commended. It's awesome. And this isn't the first year. This is a track record. There's decades of track record of managing our finances well, and I think it's one of Temecula's hallmarks. And then lastly, earlier in the agenda, Mr. Mayor, you and Councilman Ron were integrally involved in the I-15 task force. And for the public, it was in the mid-year adjustments, but we, the council approved $600,000 as seed money for I-15 auxiliary lane project that will run northbound from Temecula Parkway to Ranch California Road. Now, $600,000 is not the total cost of that project, but Caltrans is putting up $1.2 million. We have a $4 million nut to crack, which we're going to be talking with the stakeholders in the region, and we hope to expedite that and have that improvement under construction in 24 months. And that is at the speed of light.
Yeah.
And so I just didn't want that opportunity, and I don't know, Mr. Mayor or Mr. Ron, if you guys want to add anything with respect to either of those items.
Thank you, Mr. City Manager. Did you want to say something?
Yeah, it's just amazing work done on that. Not just the speed at which this is happening now, because I know when we first started that conversation, they had said at that meeting, you know, yes, we can absolutely do this, and we will definitely be breaking ground in about 7 years. So it was nice to see it accelerated, and I know we had to put some real skin in the game, but definitely worthwhile. And then as far as the pending federal grants and other processes, I think we've really got a lot of traction now, no pun intended, to help resolve our traffic woes on the 15. And that said, I'll just preemptively say I won't be at the next council meeting, first one in March, because we'll be back in D.C. advocating after that grant is filed, advocating with the Department of Transportation and our representatives. So hopefully we're successful this time.
Thank you, Council Member Dr. Ron, and appreciate the amount of time you go back east to do your lobbying. It really pays off for the city, so thank you for that. I'm going to add a few things to both of your comments, so the public's aware and just to reacquaint everybody. Everybody knows the 15 freeway is a mess, particularly in the morning and in the evenings. What not everybody knows is that that's not a Temecula problem. Temeculans aren't the only ones using that freeway. In fact, we started the Move I-15 Forward Task Force, and that was the city council who did that. And we got all the stakeholder cities together, Marietta, Lake Elsinore, Menifee, Wildomar, Canyon Lake. Am I leaving out anybody? The federal agencies, the tribal agencies, and we worked for about a year and a half to identify the problem and then come up with solutions, and we gathered data. Interestingly enough, most of the trips during peak hours are going and coming from Murrieta. So what we've now done in working with Caltrans, and I have to give a shout out to Caltrans because they have been superb in how they have worked with us. In fact, they came up with grant funds that if we'll match, we're going to do this extra lane, which will be an acceleration lane that'll help move traffic. Without belaboring the point, most of the problem there is not a capacity issue, it's a movement issue. You have a lot of people coming down the freeway trying to move to the 15 side or go to the 215 side, and everybody's trying to transition to the Y. That's causing a lot of backups. So there's plenty of capacity. Not a good adequate way to maneuver. So now we're going out to our stakeholders, the people who impact traffic, and we have enough data, particularly cell phone data. When you use Waze and Google and all of that, it's very accurate. We can tell where all the trips are going, and we can tell where they're coming from as well. And now we're going to go to the stakeholders and say it's not just a Temecula problem. Everybody needs to step up to the plate. We certainly are, and continue to do so, and that's just the way we are. As the Traffic Safety Commission has demonstrated today, as the Community Services Commission has demonstrated, as well as all our other commissions as well, the Planning Commission as well, and the Old Town Review Board. So, long end of meeting speech, but I'm glad you brought it up, Mr. City Manager, because in the heat of the budget adjustments, I forgot to bring it up. Mr. City Attorney, anything?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, we had a closed session tonight, but there's no reportable actions under the Brown Act.
Okay, so just a heads up, I'm going to go ahead and call for an adjournment of the Temecula City Council meeting, but nobody go anywhere.
because I'm going to convene another meeting. So I'll take a motion to adjourn the Temecula City Council meeting till
meeting
March 12th.
Second.
That's Mayor Pro Tem Edwards, or excuse me, Councilmember Edwards, and Councilmember Ron. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Temecula City Council meeting is adjourned. Now I'm going to convene.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes.
Sorry to
go ahead.
Be the bearer of bad news, but you have to wait until 8 o'clock.
Oh.
Because it's a special meeting that was set for 8
Very
o'clock.
Very good. Very good. So.
Well, you're going to have to entertain us, Mike.
Stand up.
Just okay.
Break out the hula skirts.
Okay. Now, you know, last week I tried something and it didn't go over too well, okay? But I have these coupons.
Don't go there.
For Bahama Bucks, okay? Now, how many people have had Bahama Bucks before? Can we see a show of hands? Okay. So are there any young people out there? You guys, Pumas, Golden Bears, Wolfpack, that want to come up and just... We have our theme for the year is Temecula love. Come on up and just tell us what you love about Temecula. One, two, three words or five sentences, I will give you a coupon. Okay?
I see a young lady in the fourth row with a Batman shirt on.
See some stirring.
Should get up here and...
Just come on. Just come on. It's no big deal, really. Just come on up. We want to know what you love about the town.
Dun, dun, dun.
Oh, so Jennifer's
just say your name and just tell us what you love. Right up here to the mic.
Good evening, sir. I'm Alec Martinez. And when I first grew up, I grew up in Hemet, which it was a very bad city at the time, in the early 2000s. But what I do love about Temecula is that I always feel safe and at home, especially when walking around at the street. So yeah, that's what I really appreciate about it.
Thank you
Good job.
For your courage and guts. Here's your coupon. Come on down. Thank you, young
Good
man.
Job.
Young man, your name?
I am Lincoln Linkogel. One thing I love about Temecula is I always feel very safe as well as the young man said.
Right.
But I also have a question. I'm a homeowner off of Pava Road.
Right.
And I'm still speaking on the regards of the potholes.
Right.
The amount of potholes off of Pava going towards Wine Country, it's a vast amount. It's along with the mudslides, or not mudslides, but runoff
from
properties, it is causing a serious, serious hazard off of.
So here you go. When you hit the middle of Butterfield Stage Road and Pava, you're on Pava, and you get to the middle of it. That's the city-county line. Okay, and if you're just east of that middle of the road, you're in the county. And that's where all the potholes are. Okay. No, most people wouldn't know that. Lincoln, you're a stand-up guy, buddy. Here's your Bahama box.
Sorry.
Okay.
All right.
Nice to meet you. Thanks. Anybody else?
Oh, they're afraid now.
Come on. It's all about just kicking back. Here we go. Young lady, welcome. What's your name?
My name is Alicia Hernandez, and one thing that I love about Temecula is the diversity of people here and the acceptance that everyone, and like the love that everyone has for each other.
That is awesome.
That's
Thank you
true.
For coming up. Here you go.
Good
nice
job.
To meet you. Anybody else? Oh, come on. I see you guys talking back there. Anybody else? We have a minute to kill.
You're going to leave and say, oh, I wish I'd gone up there.
Bahama Bucks, 100 flavors, mix them any way you want. With ice cream, without ice cream. I got the coupons because I said I would plug Bahama Bucks. So just roll with it. Who else?
Peter Thorson is just squirming over there right now.
Mr. Mayor, we are at 8
Okay.
Oh, thank God. Saved by the bell.
Hallelujah.
Okay. And moving on.
Okay, I'm going to give one more opportunity to one more speaker. Anyway, here she comes. All right, here we go. Or we might have two. Here we got two more. Mr. Thorson, am I okay?
Yeah, you're okay.
Okay, thank you. Go for it. Your name, young lady?
Hi, my name is Joanna Hunk.
And I'm Madeline Malho.
And?
What we love about Temecula is that it's a family community.
Yeah.
So. Very welcoming.
Thank you very much. Come on up, get your coupons. Nice to meet you.
See, Barbara. That was so easy.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Thorson. You keep us on the straight and narrow. We will now convene a joint meeting of the Temecula City Council and the Temecula Community Services District. Do we have any let the record reflect all council members and board members are here. Do we have any public comment?
We do not, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, so we have one business item, adopt a resolution finding that an emergency exists within the meeting of public contract code section 22035 and appropriate funding for emergency repairs. May we have a staff report?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. The item before you tonight is regarding the expenditures that have taken place and that are yet to take place as we mop up from the storms that City Manager Adams mentioned and highlighted in the closing statements of our previous meeting. We are able to take forward this item so that we can go directly out to contractors, contract with them directly, and not necessarily have to go out to the public bidding requirements included in the public contract code. We're seeking authorization to enter into contracts up to $500,000 in total using that method of contracting. I believe the public works crews have expended roughly $150,000 up to $200,000 to date. We still got yet repairs to make. The major one that we encountered as a result of this most recent storm was the one everyone's familiar with on Inez Road, just south of Paba. Those repairs were completed late yesterday, if I recall correctly. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the resolution will allow us to handle those items in that fashion. And then we're seeking appropriations as you are sitting as the city council of $200,000 from undesignated Measure S fund balance to cover the cost of the estimates to date, as well as $20,000 as you sit as the board of directors of the Community Services District to cover the repairs that were necessary to Leifer Road, which is a dirt road out in Nicholas Valley, and its maintenance is funded by service level R assessments on those benefiting properties out there in that area. That completes my staff report, and I'm happy to answer any questions.
Thank you. Are there any questions of staff right now? Mm-hmm. Okay, we don't see any questions. Do we have any requests to speak?
We do not.
Okay, so I'll entertain, unless there's any conversation we want to have amongst ourselves, I'll entertain a motion.
Move approval.
Second.
That was Council Member Edwards, seconded by Council Member Ron. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously. I'm going to go ahead and adjourn this joint meeting to our next, one said the 12th.
Adjourn it, period.
And this one says the 26th. Let's see. Hold on a second.
It's got it.
The last one, when I adjourned the Temecula Council meeting was March 12th. This one says March 26th. I believe it's March 12th. Okay, sounds good. So I'm going to adjourn this meeting until our regularly scheduled meeting on March the 12th. Good night, everybody.